I always thought I'd die in the line of duty. Caught in the crossfire of the endless gang wars or riots that were part of my daily life. But as a cop in Vanguard City, I was ready for it. Yeah, I was ready. I was one of the lucky people. I had a job, a wife, a child, a roof over my head. I could live within the specter of death if it meant leaving behind a legacy, a piece of me. But now, I've got nothing. In a few minutes, I'll be dead, and I won't feel the pain anymore. The pain of knowing that I couldn't even save her. Things I've seen, that I've done, they all seem surreal, like some faded memory of another life. But this pain is all too real. It's all that remains of what was once my life. This must be our fate. We have lived as fools for ages, unaware of our own false existence and our inevitable demise. We should have seen this coming, and maybe we could have stopped them. But now, it's too late.
The sacrifice we send to you, have praise our lords. Take this offering, Moshe sent with.
Sometimes I wonder if my life before this chaos ever really existed, or if it's just something I've imagined. Maybe this inversion of my life, this hell that has literally turned my world upside down, is just part of some warped dream or delusion. Whatever it is, it will all be over soon. Soon enough.
Davis, where are you going?
Leo, I told you already. I gotta run home for a minute. You can wait here if you want. I'll pick you up on my way back.
I got nothing to do with you, partner. I'll take a ride with you. you going home for a... Sorry, you think I can take a hint after all these years? Hey, I could wait in the car while you do your thing.
That's really funny. I'm not going home for, today's Layla's birthday, you know, and, might not make it home till late, so I want to give her a present before bedtime. You know how it is.
No. I really don't. You're going soft on me, man. You're even wearing a bracelet.
That's a friendship bracelet.
A friendship bracelet? What's that, the new fad?
Something like that. You know, you give it to someone you love and wear one yourself. It's what all the kids are asking for.
Wow, and you're wearing one too. You do have a sensitive side after all.
Being a dad changes things. Start looking at the world a bit differently.
Yeah, but sometimes you can take it overboard. Like that picture you got on the dashboard. I mean, how many convicts do you think are gonna intimidate with all that happiness staring at them from the front seat?
Convicts? I'm not worried about intimidating cons. They know what I can do if they act out.
Watch it! Wow, that was close. We should follow that guy. What do you think?
Nah, just radio it in. Traffic guys will take care of it.
Yeah, I know. Priorities. We got a press to drop on. Station L23 to station C10. We have a code 5 on Highlander. I repeat, a code 5.
Oh, shit! What the hell was that?
I have no fucking idea! Hey, did you hear that?
Let's grab the weapons. We have to find out what's going on here.
You're right, let's move.
Eyewitnesses have reports of attack citywide. All citizens must report back to C-10.
Come on, let's move. Seen a gun like this before.
Who the hell would need guns like this? We should call Central and check in. This might be citywide.
I left the radio in the car. I'll go back and see what I can find out.
Call C-10. I want to make sure that Kara and Layla are safe.
Okay. What the hell? This thing is floating.
Hey, Leo, we gotta go.
Do that. I just
put it there.
To the parking lot and...
Oh, shit!
Stairs, third floor. Let's go. Watch it!
Yes. How the hell did this get up here?
Don't know, but we gotta get upstairs. Path is blocked. Let's find another way.
Shit. I want that.
The whole building is falling apart. We need to hurry. We'll be right behind you.
Come on. Your place is on the third floor, right? We're close now.
Did you see that?
Come on, Carol, please!